This is the Vivo Y29, and you see that small black dot at the top here? Well, that is the remote control sensor. So with the Y29, you can control any electronic or appliance in your home. For example, I'm going to try and control my TV, and you can see that it is working. That's the user interface I'm using for my LG TV, but you can actually control anything in your home, including TVs, soundbars, home theaters, fans, air conditioning, and today I'm going to show you how to do that using the smart remote application available on this phone. The smart remote control app is available on the app drawer, so just select it. As you can see, I only have one thing set up, and that is for LG TV, and which, as you have seen, is working. The inputs are available here, and if I select antenna, there is one thing that I cannot do, and that is change the channels. I don't know why they didn't use these buttons for changing the channel, because right now you just have to memorize the number of channel that you want and you press OK for the channel to change. But today I'm going to show you how to set up for something very totally different, and that is for my Technosat satellite decoder here. Now, to set up a completely new device, just tap the plus button at the bottom right and select whatever device you have. As you can see, we have a lot of things here, from air conditioner, set-top box, TV box, all the way to camera, DVD player, and water heater at the bottom. What I have is a set-top box, and that's what I'm going to select. Now, I can search for it in this long list, but to be faster, I'm just going to search for it by typing. That's at the one at the top, Technosat. Aim the back of your phone at the device and tap the button below to confirm if there is a response. Any response from the device, just say no. And then you see, keep trying until the device responds. And there we have it, the device is off. So I'm just going to confirm it here, yes. You can change the name or just use the one that is available there. Use now, and I'm just going to turn it on back again. You can see it is on at the bottom here. And with this device, you can see I can be able to change the channels on this device. So I don't know why these buttons were not available on LG TV. Even the volume, that's the volume there, and the mute. The mute is also working at the top there. So let's try something totally different, my LG home theater. And for that, I'm just going to tap the plus button again and then select the type of thing. I think this time around, I'm going to select DVD player. Select LG. I'm going to turn it on. It doesn't work. Again. And there you have it. It is on. So any response from the device? Yes. I'm just going to use it. Can see the volume is working, the mute also working. These are for controlling the media, which I don't have. I mostly use the optical directly from my TV. These other buttons don't seem to do anything. So another button I can't quite seem to have is this function button here. This is for changing the functions or sources. It will be very nice if I had that button on this remote control interface. But again, this is something that can be added later on with an update. And finally, let me try my Vitron TV. Right now the TV is on standby. Select the plus button, add TV, then search for the brand, in which case it's Vitron. There we have Vitron. Is the TV on? It's off. So we test the button, nothing is working, so I'm just going to select no. There we have it, the TV is on, and now I just need to confirm, yes, the TV is on. It works, but does it work perfectly? No, it doesn't, but it's better than nothing. And finally, I want to address something that will come up in the comments below, and that is, can you use this phone with a smart remote control app to control a smart television? Well, if you have a smart television and Wi-Fi in your home, I recommend you just use an application like Google Home with your Google TV and maybe the ThinQ app with your LG TV. It's much simpler than that. The smart remote control app is for controlling the bare necessities. And that's things like changing the channels, the volume, manipulating the settings, and such. So that's it. I hope you learned something new today. If so, please leave a like, subscribe, and please watch my other videos about the Vivo Y29. I dropped this phone on quite a number of surfaces and it didn't break. It's quite a nice phone. So that's it. See you on the next video and goodbye.